Hi guys, this is Asta. Today we're going to talk about polyrhythm. Now what exactly polyrhythm is? Now poly means more than one. So playing more than one rhythm at the same time is called as polyrhythm. But this definition is not complete in itself because we have to know the relationship between the two different rhythms. Then we will realize whether it is a polyrhythm or not. So first let's see what is not a polyrhythm. So we're going to take a quarter note as one beat, and if we divide this quarter note into two equal parts, it's going to give me eighth notes, two eighth notes. So two beats or two notes in one beat. So it's going to go like one and two and three and. And if I divide this same one beat, same quarter note into four equal parts, it's going to give me 16th notes, four parts, four notes in one beat. So I have to play like 1 E and a 2 E and a 3 E and a. Now 2 and 4 can be divided into each other. They have a common factor. So it's not called as a polyrhythm. I'll play 16 notes in the left hand and I'll play 8th notes in the right hand. So it's going to go like 1 E and a 2 E and a. So the 8th note is actually coinciding in the 16th note. That's because 16th note is actually derived by the 8th notes. So this is not polyrhythm. But if I divide this one beat, for example, into three equal parts, it will give me triplets. Now I'm playing two against three. Now two and three cannot be divided into one another. They do not have a common factor. So this will be called as a polyrhythm. Now this triplet will be played like one triplet, two triplet, triplet, and these 8th notes will be played like 1 and 2 and 3 and. So if I play them together, it's going to sound like this. In the left hand I'll play triplets, right hand I'll play 8th notes. So you see here the notes are not coinciding each other, which gives us polyrhythm. Now we'll see how to actually play polyrhythm. So here we're going to take an example of 2 against 3 only. We are playing 2 notes against three notes in one beat. So first we'll take lowest common multiple of them, which is 6 here, and we're going to divide the one beat into 6 equal fragments like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And now I have to distribute the 8th notes, that means 2 notes equally into these 6 fragments. So it's going to, one note is going to be on the first beat and second note on the fourth beat. So I have distributed them equally. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's the two notes going equally in one beat. Now I have to distribute three notes equally in one beat. So I'll distribute it accordingly. So on 1, 3 and 5, equally distributed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, to play the polyrhythm, I have to play these two rhythms at the same time. So, in the right hand, I will play a note on 1 and a note on 4. And in the left hand, I will play on 1, 3 and 5. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No, I played opposite. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this gives me the rhythm of 2 against 3. Similarly, you can do it also 3 against 4 or any other polyrhythm. So polyrhythms are actually more exciting than the normal rhythms. It's actually worth trying. And if you think this video was helpful, then please like, subscribe, whatever you can do, and above all, keep practicing. Thank you so much.